Welcome to Keeping 100 Coach Jones Show on this great Wednesday. I do mean Wednesday. How you doing, Mr. Omar?
Doing good. How are you?
How you doing, Coach Jones?
I'm doing great. We had another heartbreaking loss. You know, I heard something Nick Saban said that really stuck with me. He said, in order to get to the top, you got to go through adversity. I think this year we're going through some adversity. We're going through some tough losses. We got two losses on the year and about two total points in overtime. And, you know, they're going for two to win it. So I think that that's going to be a blessing in disguise. I think it has motivated us. It has us playing with a chip on our shoulder. And I think it's going to have us going into the playoffs playing physical, playing discipline, and playing tough football. Because anytime you lose like that, you always go back to the drawing board and you evaluate things that you can fix and things that you can do to get you better. So I think that's what's happening right now. Our kids are motivated. They understand the sense of urgency that we have going into the playoffs. So I'm looking forward to how we handle these next couple weeks, this week versus Durant and then the first round of playoffs.
Well, Coach, I mean, I know we talked about that. We'll get into a little of that. We'll dig deep in that, as you know, as the show goes on. But I just wanted, you know, let people know we got a special guest today, Mr. Omar Brown, the outstanding defensive back and wide receiver. Did get him, got the first touchdown in the game Friday night against Coweta. This young man just received his first offer to go play college football for Dodge City Junior College. You know, I mean, the young man just, I mean, if you look at him, man, he has it built to play corner, tall and long arms, played basketball, just a great athlete, on and off the court, you know, just a good young man, you know. I tell you, you know, Dodge City, you know, and I tell you, before the season's over, he's going to get many more than that.
Oh, absolutely, because, Coach. He'll have a lot of people
looking at him. I tell you, he got the perfect size. He got what everybody wants. You know, he can catch the football. You know, they talk about most DBs become DBs because they can't catch. Well, that's not his problem. He can catch.
Yes, sir.
You know, I want to give it to him Friday night, man, stepping up and, you know, having a big ball game on the offensive side of the ball and defensive side of the ball. So, Omar, I mean, tell us a little bit about yourself.
Well, my name's Omar Brown. From Dale City, Oklahoma, born and raised here.
Yes, sir.
And I raised in a family of two, mom and dad, and my little brothers and sisters, raised up cousins. And they always bullied me and stuff, tried to get me tough and stuff like that. But they moved out, and then it's only just me and my brother to help them take care of my mama. And then my mom and dad split up, so I'm just helping around the house with my mother and stuff.
That's it, man. That's it. That's big time because, you know,
yes, sir.
That's what it's all about. You know, you stepping up being a man of the house, man, you know, to your brothers and, you know, to your sister. You know, when did you start playing the game of football?
I started playing the game of football when I was seven, but I took like 5 years off, and then I came back my freshman year and started playing again.
So you was a basketball player also?
Mm-hmm. Yes,
you know,
sir.
I heard good things about you on the court, too. You know, I know last year you didn't play, but I know Lenny Hatcher would love to have you back on that court, man, to help that Dell City team, you know, get another state championship because, you know.
Yes, sir.
You know, the way you're playing right now, Omar, it is really good, you know, if you are a two-sport athlete because it gives these college coaches.
Track, too.
Okay, yeah, track. So, but I'm saying just on that basketball court, you know, I don't know how tall are you, about 6'3", 6'4"?
Yeah, about 6'3", 6'3.5".
And, you know, you're already long, but, you know, when these college coaches, I know they can't wait to get their hands on you because they're going to put a little bit more meat on you, man. Just the way you cover and you catch the football, it just shows you your athletic ability because, you know, nowadays these college coaches, they want these big corners, you know. They want, you know, and not only can you play corner, but they can put a little bit more meat on you and move you into, you know, strong safety, free safety. So, I mean, that's pretty good. But like I said, I just want to tell you, you know, congratulations to you on getting that scholarship. And like I said, you're going to have many more. That ain't the first one knocking on the door, man. Once they, you know, people start knowing a little bit more about you, man, is, you know, especially going to playoffs, is when you get these coaches and come out and see you a little bit more. But like I said, I really like it how you said, you know, you stepped up, you know, became a big brother and a father figure to you, you know, to your family and helping your mom out, because that's the most important thing is helping mom out, because she's the one that you know, brought you into this world. Well, Coach Jones, tell us a little bit about Omar. I mean, you know.
Well, Omar's a unique athlete. Like you said, he didn't play early on, so he's kind of raw. He's learning the game. He started as a freshman. We knew right then and there that he was going to have the size to be successful. He's that typical story. If you hear guys, you always be like, man, you see those basketball players that are 6'2", 6'3", and they don't play football. You're like, man, if that kid would play football, he would get a lot of more opportunities.
Yes, sir.
You know, and Omar he bought into that concept, and he's been great for us. He's also a track member. He runs track as well. He was on our 4x1 and 4x2 that placed in state. Our 4x2 relay, 4x200 relay placed third, and our 4x1 relay placed fourth. So he's the anchor leg of both of those relays, so he has good speed. He's a 10-900 kid. I think this year in track, he's going to really show people who he is, and he's going to be able to bring his name up in the track area as well. He's going to be right there with Kanijah. I think the both him and Kanijah will be competing in the 100 and 200 to see who the state champion is, because he has that type of speed. Anytime you can get a unique size DB that is 6'3", that's long, that can run, plays with confidence, can press well, you got a weapon. And he's been on the island all year. The last time he's given up a catch was against McAllister, and it was a bang-bang play against the number eight from McAllister. That's a great kid. So Omar has really stepped it up in a lot of different ways. And he also can play outside backer, nickelback, safety. So he brings a lot of unique ability because he can play multiple positions, and he has that size. So Dodge City came in. Coach Tarr is a great guy. This is his first year there. You know, Ethan Lawrence signed there last year.
Mm-hmm.
It's a great program. He's building it up from the bottom up and getting a good foundation. One of the things he said to me is like, Coach, that kid with his size and his ability can have 8 Division I's offers by 2023, the spring of 2023, because he'll be qualified going into it. So he goes play 1 year junior college. He can have 8 Division I offers. Which I was told by Coach Tarr by the end of the spring semester. So, and this year's not over yet. I think as people come in and watch film and people kind of see his size, he's going to have a lot of other opportunities. He's going to have some tough decisions to make, but he's warranted for it. He's busted his tail. He's been grinding. He's a leader for us as well. And I'm just proud of him. I'm proud that I could put him on the island, get some of the best receivers in the state, and he's held it on. And not only offensively, you saw last week him catching – a big pass over the middle. He's a unique body because he can play like a tight end type body. Mm-hmm. He can play an outside receiver. So he brings a lot of different tools that help us out as a program. I'm just excited to see him mature and grow as well. You know, Omar wasn't always the toughest player early on in his career because he was more of a basketball-minded kid, and he didn't play early on. Like he said, he took 5 years off. But the maturity that I've seen in him has been great. You know, I was real hard on him. You know, I bet at times he probably didn't think I liked him. But I saw the potential in him, and I wanted to keep pushing him and keep pushing him so he could be where he is now. So going into this last week versus Durant and going into the playoffs, I think everybody's going to be able to see Omar make a lot of big-time plays. I think they're going to be able to see his physicality. I think they're going to be able to see his leadership skills, and I think he's going to make – I've been saying it all year to our coaches. I said Omar Brown will make plays in big games to get us us the victory or keep us in the game. And even last week versus Coweta, coach, he made a couple big plays for us, a couple big tackles. He made that touchdown catch. So I'm excited to see him continue to grow. It's nothing more fulfilling to me as a man and as a coach and as a mentor to see a kid who has put in the work get a scholarship offer, because it's all about getting that education.
Yes, sir.
It's all about putting yourself in a situation to be a great father, a great uncle, a great son in the future. And you do that by going to get a scholarship and getting your education paid for.
That's it. Well, Coach, like I tell you, you know, like I said, you know, he's coming to his own. You know, in the last few games, he's stepped up and made great plays for you guys. You know, if you catch my show, you know, that drops today, one of the things my brother had said about Omar, he's like, man, that young man is open. He was open all night. And I just tell you, you're going to be a matchup problem going to the playoffs against any team. Having Kanijah on one side, I know, you know, you guys kind of.
You know what? I don't mean to cut you off, too. You know what I like about it? Most kids would have been throwing their hands up.
Yeah.
Complaining, I'm open, this and that. No, Omar jogged back, got ready on defense.
He did. He
was on special teams. He never complained. He was open a few times. I think that's going to continue to happen.
Yes, sir.
The focus point on Jalen Sweet, Kanijah Thomas, Braylon Adama, even DeKalen Godwin, Day-Day, D-Nice, all the focus points on them, and then Omar just kind of sneaks in.
No play. Yes, sir.
Even versus Choctaw, and you said it when we kicked that field goal, you said, hey, DLC is going to win the game because you feel like that field goal was put over the top. We don't get that field goal if Omar doesn't pick up. I think it was either 3rd and 12. You know, he put us in position.
He always
makes those couple plays that doesn't get highlighted as much because his name is not tagged to all, like Kanijah's and Jaden. But he makes those couple plays that's put us in position to get a victory.
Well, Coach, you might not know about him now, but I tell you, when this young man goes off to college, people's going to know who Omar Brown is. Because I said, whatever school gets him, because like I said, he might go to junior college for a year or two, But whatever D1 school gets him is going to get a great player. Because like I said, you know, I even said something to you the other night about him. I said, man, I felt like you got on Omar because, you know, he was looking at you like he had that look like, coach, I let you down. But those are the young men you want to coach because they don't want to let you down.
Yes, sir.
And, you know, you talk about the game the other night, man. You know, the game could have won either way. He went in overtime.
Yeah.
Like I said, I know we'll dig into that. But, you know, with the conditions you had, man, I mean, it's so funny. After the game, I took a picture.
Yeah,
and I didn't know how wet I was until I saw the picture.
It was like that slow rain.
Yeah,
Philly didn't feel it, but then you like you're so soaked. Like,
you were soaking wet, and you're asking these young men to go out there and make plays, and you know, and a lot of times, you know, you think of things, but like most of them probably should have took their gloves off because you know when the gloves get wet,
they get
real slippery.
Absolutely.
So, but like I said, I think Omar. It's going to, you know, continue to do great things going into the playoffs. You know, I know you got to finish up with Durant this Friday night, but I just think going into the playoffs, man, he'll be a big factor. Because like I said, the other night he ran by everybody. You know,
absolutely.
I know we didn't get the ball to him, but I just think that, hey, you know, now he's a guy that when you're watching film, well, you got to count for him. If not, you can't just put help over top for Knigel or Swede. You got to recognize this young man
absolutely.
Too. Well, Omar, before we let you go, man, I know, like you said, you're a family man, but you know, tell me what's your go-to meal, and you know, on Friday night, what you got in the headphones?
I got in the headphones. I'm gonna just focus on myself, focus on making all the plays, focus on helping my team win, and then we can just control what we can control.
What kind of music you got? I know you got a little bit. I know
some strong. Like
you, everything's on the line.
Game. What you got in the headphones?
I probably got to listen to the Kamikaze by YoungBoy.
Okay. Thursday night meal. You know, Mama get you a good meal because I know I'm an over easy and grits. Yeah, that's what I like. So if you had a hot meal, what would you want to have?
I'll probably get like a Salisbury steak with a side of mashed potatoes.
That's what I'm talking about. A little corn too.
Yeah.
Now we talking, Omar. Now we talking. So I can't mess with no gravy. I want mine. A little butter. A little potatoes. A little bacon bits on it. Yeah, now we talking, Omar. But you know what, man? I tell you right here, I've been around the team for 2 years and just watching you. You're a quiet young man, and that's what you like because you're going to go a long way.
Yeah.
Granted, you might not have all the stars and all the hype now, but when Coach Jones looked back 2 to 3 years back and people are going to say, Omar Brown played for Dell City, who was that young man? He played on the other side of Knigel. You're going to get a lot of recognitions here in the next few years. I'm telling you right now. Stay humble, young man, and great things going to come to you.
Yes.
And at the end of the day, when you do make it big, take care of Mama. All right? Well, folks, we'll be right back after one of our sponsors, Keep It 100 to Coach Jones. So we'll be right back.
You tired of going out to your trash can, having to smell so bad? Well, no further. Call Spiffy Cans. He cleans, disinfects, sanitizes. 405-423-8824. Or go to SpiffyCansOK.com. Spiffy Cans, he's your man.
Spiffy Can, he's your man.
Welcome back to Keep It 100, Coach Jones Show. Coach, how you doing?
Doing good, man. It's good to have that young man on, Omar.
Yes,
like
sir.
We said, he has a unique talent with the height and size that he has. And
man,
you said it perfectly, man. He is going to blow up. I think he's going to be a name that we're going to hear about on the collegiate level, wherever he goes.
Oh, yeah.
I think he has the potential not only playing in collegiate, but should possibly pros. When you have that size, Coach, and you can run like he has.
You can run.
Dude, that's very unique. It's not a lot of corners that can run like that. I think the last one I seen was the Choctaw kid, and we saw he went to OU. I don't know where he is now. Is he still there? But
I think he's still there. Okay, Jordan Mukes.
He reminds me a lot of that kid. And
he's probably a little bit more football IQ, you know. I mean, you can just tell the kid he's still raw. But you can just kind of tell, the potential he has, man. I mean, it's like I was trying to tell him before he left, you know, just is what he can do with the football, you know. A lot of DBs can't catch.
Yes.
And he can catch. He
absolutely
can play both sides of the ball. And,
yes, sir.
And he can go play college receiver for somebody and be a standout.
Yeah.
Kind of like those guys over at, K-State.
Yeah, just one of those bigger
TCU,
receiver kids, absolutely. And I didn't mention enough. He is going to show a lot of people what he could do on the track. He is very special.
Well, guess what, Coach? He just said a little sneak peek. He's going to go back to the court. He'll help Lenny. I think he can help Lenny. And he says he plays a post, you know, kind of a hybrid position. And, you know, that's good. That just shows you how athletic he is. So
yeah.
I know Lenny might have lost one, But he gave one. One. Yeah, that's how it works, Coach. One door opens, one door closes, another one opens.
Absolutely.
Well, Coach, I'm going to tell you, going into that game, it was all for the marbles. You had number one versus number I don't know what number. Every week it changes, man. You look at each poll. I'm going to say number one versus number two going into last week. A great game. People didn't get to make it. It was a rainy game, It started off, with homecoming and trying to get everybody lined up with the parents and flowers and all that.
Yeah.
And you know as well as I know, man, the intensity wasn't there because got so much going on. And kids' last game and it's raining and everything is kind of, rain is kind of makes you want to stay in the house and relax anyway. It's just what it is. But I tell you, two great teams went at it. I will say that.
Absolutely.
Kawita came in with a great game plan. I thought you and the coaching staff had a great game plan. You shut them down. A team that's averaging 49 points. You guys averaging 45, 49 points also. You both, there's two heavyweight fighters going at it. And I tell you, at the end, they won with a two-point conversion.
Yeah.
Both teams, had turnovers. I think this is the first game that we've done all year that a team out had more yards than you. You guys had 265, they had 330.
Yeah.
It's really weird. If you look at the game, it's completely, it's even, you can't go wrong for, what they did or, what you guys did. But, you kind of said before the show, it makes you sit down, you lost two games last year, going to the whole year, but, you got two losses this year. But, we both kind of got a shock that, where you finished up. You had a chance to go from being first to winning district or going all the way down to winning, losing and being third.
Yeah.
Well, McAllister decided they're going to take Friday night off.
I guess. That
was a poker. Yeah, that's just
probably. That's why everybody's looking at playoff seeding and positioning. But who knows what's going to happen. Nobody picked McAllister to lose, so anything can happen tomorrow night and Friday night. So you just got to focus on this week. And speaking of the game, It was a hard loss to lose two games this year and only lose by 2 points total. It's tough. The positive that I take from it is we played our worst game offensively of the year.
Yes, sir.
We played our worst game discipline wise. We had a lot of busts defensively and offensively, just little minor busts, drop passes, penalties, turnovers. So if you look at all those things as a head coach and you're like, what could we have done better? And you look at the penalties and the turnovers. To lose to the best team in 5A, the number one team in this point, because they've proven it, to lose to them by 1 point and to play your worst game, it gives you confidence that we can get those things cleaned up.
No, yeah, you're
right
there.
We can work on those things and get into the playoffs and we can make a run for it. That defense was special. They were flying to the ball. They were communicating. They're a very experienced squad. But it was a heavyweight match and it was two great defenses going at it. It's unique to have two offenses coming into a game, both averaging 49 points equally. Both teams were averaging 49 points. Both defenses have held both offenses in regulation to 10 points. That's 39 points underneath your weekly average. So I told the offensive staff, I said, guys, if we get in the playoffs, if we didn't get another big game, we hold somebody 39 points underneath their average, we got to go win that game.
We can win it.
So we know what we need to do offensively. We know that we need to get back to the drawing board and evaluate ourselves and see what we need to fix. But I think the style of kid that we have, I always bring up last year how we lost the first game and we won 9 games in a row. We went into the playoffs confident, but we never had that hiccup to make us evaluate ourselves. And then when you lose in the playoffs, it ain't no more evaluating. You're checking your shoulder pads
in. So check it in.
For us to be able to evaluate ourselves, look in the mirror, I think we're going to make the corrections that's going to help us versus Durant. It's going to help us going into the first round of playoffs. And I'm excited to see these young men take care of business.
Like I said, you look at your offensive, numbers, you put up, D. Goodwin, he was 9 for 22. Missed on some balls that should have been caught, But like I said, he was 9 for 22, 149 yards, 2 touchdowns,
You know what's crazy about that, T? Last year, people would have been like, man, y'all threw the ball well.
Yeah, 149 yards because
of Virgil and the style he had. Now that's an off game. We're still throwing 450 yards, 2 touchdowns. That's an off game. So that shows you what DeKalen Godwin's been doing this year and the receivers and the offensive unit as a whole.
And I tell you, you're going to rushing, Brady Adama, not one of his better games,
Sir.
And that, had 9 carries for 21 yards.
Yeah, that's not great.
D Goodwin, D Nice, what we call him, QB, 12 carries, 80 yards. And I tell you, I will say, And I hope we get some highlights of some of his runs. Man, there's sometimes, man. And you know, this kid, young man, I'm telling you, Friday night, it was pouring down rain, and probably our average sunny day, he probably weighs 125 pounds. Yeah. You know, I mean, maybe Saturday night, I mean, Friday night, he probably weighed 130, you know, 140 because of being wet.
Yeah.
But I tell you, man, there's a couple of runs he made, Coach. That was amazing. Yeah, I mean, just, amazing. I mean, grabbed by the shoulder pads, was thrown. He looked like a ping pong machine, got thrown, bounced off, and still made the play. But I tell you, you know, he did enough, you know, to win the ball game. Yeah. You know, just a couple of things that he has to learn. And me and Coach Madonna kind of talked this morning. You got to think, this is only his ninth game.
Man, that's
He's played quarterback nine games.
That's crazy.
And he's still making great plays. And that's how it is. When you do something good, everybody loves you. You have a bad game, everybody mad at you. But he's going to keep getting better. So, you know, S. Green, he had seven carries for 31 yards.
You really like that kid, too. He's going to be special.
Number 28?
Yeah, he
gets I like him, Coach. I told you about the game. I'm not taking that from Adama. But I'm telling you, that kid could be special. You got a lot of special kids. That's what I said. You don't fall off. He's got to get – when you get – you. I still don't think you had a complete game yet with all your everybody – everybody clicking together. So I think once
I don't think we had a complete game with offense, special teams was all clicking.
And when it does happen,
it's gonna be special.
Ooh-wee. I'm telling you, it's gonna be you know, Jay Sweet, you know, he had four catches, you know, 27 yards. Yeah. Usually he's sure handed, you know, we call him sure handed Sweet.
Yeah.
And excuse me, you know, he dropped a couple, you know, Canigel, he had two big catches. You know, any other time, you know, Canigel catches that long as a touchdown.
Oh, man.
You know, I mean, when he caught that one, I said, ball game.
Me
and, you
too.
Know,
so
Mason, you know, did caught. He did. I mean,
Mason's
I was really, and it was a great play. I mean, great
angle by
great
Mason
to make sense.
To continue to go. Most people would have kind of slowed down. Mason kept going full speed and that eventually saved them the game. Mason's a great player.
Yeah.
I knew he was a great player coming in, but I'm even more impressed with his toughness after that game. He is a great, tough football player.
Great high school football.
Yeah, he plays for class too. He's not
he does.
Talking.
He's not talking.
On Twitter, talking mess. He's just a great guy that goes in and that whole defense and that whole coaching staff and players. They got a workers mentality, blue collar.
That's it.
They really are.
Bring your lunch pail to work and let's go to work.
Coach Harper's done a great job this year. Like you said, I think he needs to be coach of the year. He could beat us, McAllister, and take care of business.
Three salty teams.
Yeah, that's and Carl Albert. That's three salty teams. So he's a great coach. He's doing a great job there.
Yeah, you know, Mr. Omar Brown, who we had on the show earlier, you know, one catch for 22 yards, and I mean, there's a couple of times Omar was
open.
You know, we didn't get the ball to him, but that, I mean, those things that you see watching film. Hey, you know, we come back to it later down because, like you said, we spoke on it earlier. Having Canigel Sweet, now you got this young man that you got to count for. Now, if not, he'll leave you standing there and he's scoring all day because he's that young man that might get in the state championship game, semifinal games, and have three or four touchdowns.
Yeah.
Because now you got to count for this guy. You can't put one-on-one coverage with a Canigel Sweet. So if you do, you got to pick your poison.
Yeah,
so
he's a player.
So I tell you that. I mean, he's a great young man. I mean,
absolutely.
Just talking to him, saying a story about his mom, you know, stepping up, being the man of the house. I mean, that's big time, Coach.
Yeah.
I mean, we both know that, having, you know.
And those are the things people don't.
You don't see.
You don't see. And, you know, a lot of people are quick to judge, they'll see. But these kids are tougher than most kids because their home lives and the things that they go through, they don't let it drag them down. They use it to motivate them. And they've been real inspiring to me to see some of the stories that
that's
I would tell
stuff.
You. And I hear those things. I'm like, man, I hear Omar say that. I'm like, man, I'm glad that I was able to be part of his life.
Yes.
To him. That's awesome.
Then you end up the night, you know, Jay Burrs, you know, two catches, 31 yards. He had the other.
He's another sneaky receiver. Coach. He's a guy that always has a touchdown, two or three catches here. So him and Omar are kind of like those guys nobody talks about. But if you look at you, you got Canigel, Jalen Sweet, you got Foreman, you got Adama, and then you say Omar and Josiah. So you got those couple guys that kind of sneak underneath the radar because everybody puts a focus on those D1 commits. So those guys are making plays for us. I think they're going to make some plays in the playoffs to be able to help us succeed.
You know, Coach, like I said, one of the biggest things, you know, you had Sapopa with the big upset over McAllister.
Wow.
You know, no one was expecting that.
Nobody
you know,
in state.
You know, it puts you guys at the number two seed now. Yeah. You know, it makes your bracket a little bit tougher. But think about it, though. Well, you've been a state champion, you know, in high school and even in track. You know what it takes to win it all to get that ring.
What's crazy, too, this is what I told the kids. I said my junior year and senior year at Carl Albert, we started 1-3. And we did not win district. So, yes, district is very important. You want to win district, but that does not stop your goal to win a state. if you use it the correct way, if you use it as motivation, and you fix the things that you need to fix. And I think we got the program to do it. I think we got the young men and coaches to do it, so I'm excited about it. The bracket is if everything works out like it should Thursday, the bracket is going to set up some big-time games. And
Coach, they're going to be big. I mean,
yes, sir. Listen, 5A is probably the most exciting bracket.
5A is the toughest bracket because if you look at me last year using 6A small, if you look at that 6A small right now, there's three teams that can contend for the state championship. Choctaw, Stillwater, Muskogee. And Muskogee and Stillwater play each other this Thursday night.
What a game.
That'll tell you where they stand at. But over here on 5A, you're going to start off. You know, Middle City got to go take care of business this Thursday night and beat Elgin.
Shout out to Coach Hall.
Coach Hall, he started off slow. He lost the game since you put it on him.
Wow, man.
41-0.
That's crazy, man.
Coach Hall said, hey.
That's what it's about. Blocking out the naysayers and going to make a run.
Taking care of business.
Coach Hall, kudos to you, man.
All right, so Coach, this is how the bracket is set up. Middle City take care of business tomorrow night against Elgin. Be Middle City and Piedmont. Mm. Collinsville and McAllister. Collinsville is the state championship team. This is the two teams that played in the state championship last year. Two teams that played the state championship last year. And they're going to play each other in the first round. That's how I tell you how tough 5A is.
Absolutely.
So then you go down, you got Quitter and Claremore. Quitter should take care of more. Then you got Bishop McGinnis and El Reno. Another good matchup.
Yeah.
You know, Bishop McGinnis, no one's talking about Bishop McGinnis now. All you're hearing is Dell City, Carl Albert, Coweta. Those are your top three teams
Bishop
everybody's
McGinnis
talking about.
Bishop McGinnis is kind of silently doing like how Alabama's doing in the playoff rankings. Like, everybody's kind of forgetting about him. They lost a big game, but they're going to be in the mix towards the end. That's a great program. They have a great running back.
Yes, sir.
And Division I quarterback. A great coach with Coach Pierce. So they've been the mix towards the end.
And then you got Carl Albert versus Lawton MacArthur. And then you got Dell City, Bishop Kelly. Then you got Grove, Sepulpa. Grove is probably one of the sleeper teams. There's two teams in this
whole deal
that's undefeated. You got Grove and you got Quitter's, the only two teams that's undefeated in 5A.
Yeah.
And then you got Elgin and Guthrie. But, Coach, you're looking at some, these teams get the wins. And I tell you, though, if you guys take care of your business and Carl Albert take care of their business, you got two great teams that's right here, not even 5 miles apart from each other. A team that you did beat last year, but you know it's going to put them on the – they've had this Dell City game mark for a year. Like, hey, we want another shot at Dell City. I will say probably one of the hottest teams in 5A right now, getting a quarterback back. But I tell you, it's wide open. Dell City, Grove, Carl Albert. You got to put your hat out there for Miller City and Coweta. Even McAllister – but one of them gonna knock each other out.
Collinsville, I've seen Carl Albert do it for years, lose a game in the regular season and come in the playoffs. And so Collinsville's a defending state champion. Mm-hmm. Don't count them out. When you win like that, you get that cohesiveness to be able to mesh together as a program. So I wouldn't count them out either. Yeah. So it's exciting to have that many teams competing for it. This is what it's all about. Whoever holds that gold ball up at the end of the year, they're going to say we earned it because there was a lot of great football teams that were competing for it. I'm excited to see it.
Well, I know you still got one game left on the schedule. This come Thursday night, they kind of changed some things around because of the weather.
Yeah.
Kind of makes you, your weekend a little bit easier, get you a little bit more time to start preparing for, Bishop Kelly. But, you got Durant this Thursday night. I think they got a big kid.
I don't know his exact name. I believe he's 89. He's a five-star kid. When I turn on the film, he reminds me of David Stone. I believe he was a move-in from Texas. He plays physical. Coach Durant's a physical football team. We're going to have to strap our helmet up. We're going to have to get after it. They run the option. They run some two-back stuff. They're a physical football team, double tight end. So I kind of love the matchup because it gets us in a physical format before we get into the playoffs. Because Bishop Kelly or whoever we play are going to be well-coached. They're going to be disciplined. So this is a great game for us to go take care of business, for us to be physical, us to get that taste out of our mouth. I'm excited about going down there. It's a long drive, but sometimes those road trips are good. You get a lot of thinking done. But, Durant's a great football team. Coach Vargas is doing a great job there. You can definitely see the improvement that they're having. They're going to want to end their year the right way and the correct way. You got seniors playing on senior night. So I'm excited about getting down there and playing against Durant this week.
Like I said, it should be a good game. I know their record probably don't speak for how they've been playing, but, 2-7. But, like I said, that 5A is wide open, man, with all four districts, 1, 2, 3, and 4. I mean, you got some great teams come out of it. You look at Elgin and Grove both coming from 4A and moving to 5A. And
what they was 4A, huh?
Yeah, and what they've done, you know.
Grove is special. Season. Grove is 9-0.
Yeah, 9-0. You know, and like I said, I tell people that's my sleeper.
You've been saying that. It wasn't no bandwagon.
You've I mean, I've been saying that. Like week two, week three. Emmanuel Crawford is one of the best backs in the state. But, you know, I think I tell you right now, I think 5A is the toughest. I mean, you can look at 6A big. You know, I think you got two teams that just stands out. You got Bigsby and you got Union. You know, like I said, you go to 6A2, you got those three teams. You go to 5A, you got six teams, seven teams that can easily win this deal. And you go to 4A, you know, you got Cushing, you got Bethany, you know, I got Tuttle. You know what I'm saying? I mean, it's 5A is the toughest. I'm just telling you right now.
It's going to be a tough deal.
But, you know, I think you have the guys, prepared. Yeah. Like I said, you lost two games this year by a total of 2 points, 3 points. You can't hang your head on that. You got
to. Crazy team. I experienced four losses, and the last three losses in my career, we lost to Sand Springs by four, and then we lost. So our last three losses have been by six total points. So that's the consistency of the culture and the program that we build here, us and the coaches and the players. So anytime you lose, you don't want to have. What they call it when you lose, but you know you still get some positive out of it. You don't want to have that type of mindset, but you have to in this situation. They were a great team, so even though we lost, I think it's something that we can learn from. And I'm excited about getting to the playoffs. I'm excited about finishing right with Durant. I'm excited to see how this season's going to end for these seniors.
Well, Coach, before we finish up, at this point in time, you got that many great teams. Somebody's gonna lose ball game. It's hard to go undefeated. I mean, even in college football, you look at Alabama, how successful they are year in, year out. It's hard. Look at Tennessee. They got Georgia this week. Are you gonna find out what they're really made
of? One of them's gonna lose the game.
Yeah, you look at Oklahoma State. They go beat Texas. They go down to K-State and get beat. It happens, Coach. I mean, you got to play perfect ball.
That reminds me of K-State a little bit. Sepulpa. I was worried going into that game. Things were just clicking for us like it was for K-State that game.
Yeah.
Like this when everything's just going right. So Popper is a sleeper. I would not. Yes, Coach. They got a couple great receivers. They have a good quarterback. So that's a team that kind of reminds me of K-State, the style of play they play. So I wouldn't be surprised if they go out and upset someone. So it's the fourth place teams to all the way from first to fourth. It's going to be a great matchup, and I'm excited about it as a football fan.
Well, Coach, like I said, go take care of business this Friday night against Durant. You know, get ready. You have your first playoff game will be at home.
Yeah.
The second one is on the road, but it's only five minutes away. So the fans can still come out and support. I want to say I thought you had a great fan base. So senior night in the rain, people stuck it out.
5,000 people on the live stream watching. Man, that's incredible.
That's big time.
Yeah, that's incredible. That's going to a different level. And I thank the OSN live stream on the last talk show, and I'm thankful again. They continue to give the fans a great free show, a free live stream. So
yes, sir.
They don't get paid for that,
nope.
Just like you don't get paid to do this.
Yes.
So I'm thankful for these blessings that we're getting with the Del City football program, that people are taking their time and their effort to put into us for free. So we're thankful for that.
Well, Coach, like I said, I want to thank you for another great opportunity to do a show. I think next week we'll be talking about, the win over Durant, and then we'll be talking about the road to the gold ball.
Yes, sir.
If it ain't gold, it ain't right, and I know Del C's going to do it all night.
Yes,
so, Robin, look at that little TJ.
Yes, sir. Yes,
well, like I appreciate you, Coach, though, man. Like I said, I want to say real quick before we go, I love the way you were handling the loss because, and you told me, 10 years ago, and even your counterpart said, 10 years ago, Coach Jones would have been hands in the rain, but I'm telling you, man, those kids love you, man. They look up to you, man. I was just watching Omar Brown the other night.
You told me that, man. It really had me reflecting on some things. I was like, man, that's special. It makes me reflect on, choose my words wisely, because these kids really do.
They look up to you.
Me,
they love you, man.
Mentor and father feel. So that was special for you to tell me that, because I really needed to hear those types
But you got to realize, though, at the end of the day, those guys are always going to remember you, because you're like a father figure to a lot of these young men. And at the end of the day, when they come back, they're gonna always remember Coach Jones. I tell people all the time, I always remember, Dennis Huggins, call him Huggy Bear. He's my defensive back coach in Midwest City. I don't remember my college coach. I remember Huggins because Huggins would always get on to me.
Yeah.
But he always tell me what I did wrong and what I need to do to get better. And so to this day, I remember that man. I don't know if he's still alive or not, but it's a guy that I look up to. You know, and I know you look up to Coach Rose a lot.
Absolutely.
I mean, I see you in the neighborhood, you know, going, you know, and people might know each week you go, you know, hang out with him. And that's good. I mean, because Coach Rose is a big part of your life. I mean, he's helped you, you know, where you need to go, and you're doing the same thing to these young men. So it's always good to get back. You know, it's not about Coach Robert Jones playing at Oklahoma State, playing at Carl Albert, but Coach Robert Jones coaching at Dale City High School.
Giving back.
So
absolutely.
Giving back to these young men. But Coach Jones, like I said, keep your head up. You know, like Tupac would say, you know, you're going to keep grinding, keep your head up. And that's something you've done with these boys, and I noticed that Friday night, man. I know some have tears because it's their last game.
That's why I told them to get in the locker room. I said, y'all go in the locker room, but don't cry. You have nothing to hang your head about. Brown, you played a tough game. That coach made a tough call.
He did.
That was a tough call going for two.
Man, it was. I ain't gonna lie. I wouldn't have done it. I'd have kicked the field goal. Well, he might have been scared because that one field goal. That's why I say it was Queen of the Night, because the one field goal.
I think a little bit was too that he didn't know about the McAllister score. No. I think if he knew the McAllister score, he might not have done that, because that's.
But Coach said one field goal he kicked, man, it bounced and hit it, it went in. So
that might have played into it.
That might have played into it, though. Wet ball, you got to do everything right, catch, put down and kick, you know. So,
absolutely.
But like I said, it was a great game, you know. But like I said, I mean, that's what you've done the 2 years, though. You've done some great things here. So just keep grinding, keep doing your thing, and it all pay off, though. Like I said, you still got a shot at the gold ball. That ain't over yet.
No. I think since we've been here, and, you know, I've coached in maybe 20 or so games. We don't have 6 games of the week. That's pretty amazing.
That's amazing.
Yeah, that's crazy.
That's big time. Tell you what this program's doing over here.
Yes, I love that.
It's good to see some alumni come out and watch the game the other night. So that's always good, especially in the rain. Well, folks, that's another great episode of Keeping It 100 Coach Jones Show. We'll see you next week, and we'll be talking about the recap of Durant and the road to the gold ball. Never be hard to be real.